Hey, this is Digital by Computing. Today we're going to look at how to build a new server on vSphere 6.5 or 6.7. Let's look at how we do that right after this. So my name is Emilio, I work in the IT industry, and today we're going to look at the simple step on how to create a new VM on your vSphere console. So you see here that we are logged in, we've got our host, we've got our virtual machines, our storage, our network. So we've just already commissioned a brand new piece of hardware, brand new server, running ESXi, which is VMware's hypervisor. It's up and running. So this guide will not show you how to install that necessarily. We're assuming that you've already built that, and now you want to go and build your very first VM. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to log in to your ESXi host. In this case, we're on our ESXi host, or you could be connected to a vCenter environment, and you are connected via your web client, right? Via your web browser, you're connecting to your IP address of your host or your vCenter, and you're now presented with a similar screen to this. All right. First thing you want to do is you want to have an ISO of your operating system, all right? So we're gonna be installing Windows Server 2016. You need to have the ISO of 2016 to be able to go and install this particular operating system and build this VM. So there's a couple of things you could do. You could either create VM straight from here and then mount that ISO directly onto the VM, or you can copy that ISO into your data store, right? Your data store will be a physical disk somewhere. It could be the disk on your server, or it could be a disk on a separately attached piece of storage, such as a SAN or a NAS. So you'll have your data store in here. What we need to do is we need to copy that ISO, that Windows Server 2016 ISO, into the data store. There is a way to manually mount that ISO directly onto the VM, but it can be a little bit slow because it's reading that ISO directly from your hard drive, from your local hard drive. And I just like to copy it to the data store. That way I've got a permanent copy of that ISO sitting on the VMware data store. So you'll see under storage, I've got my data store. I want to right click on it and say browse, create a folder. All right, so in here, I've just created a folder called ISOs. You'll see down the bottom here, create directory, ISOs, for example. And here is my ISO that I've already copied, but all you have to do is click on upload and then navigate to where your ISO is on your physical computer, whether if it's a Windows or on a Mac, whatever it may be, and you can copy that ISO directly onto here. All right, so that may take a bit of time depending on how big your ISO is and how quick your network speed is. But once it's in there, you're good to go, and you can click on close, and then we can build the VM. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna say create or register a VM. And it's gonna go through a simple guide. You wanna create a new VM, deploy a VM from an OVA file, or register an existing virtual machine. So we're gonna be creating a brand new virtual machine. It's gonna now ask you for the name of your virtual machine. So we're just gonna call this, vCenter. All right, compatibility. This is the version of compatibility that you want for this particular VM. So if you're running in an environment that have other VMs running earlier versions, say 5.5, or 6, for example, and you go and deploy a 6.5 installation, for example, you won't be able to use this VM on earlier versions of ESXi under 6.5. So it's up to you what you want to pick. In the demo, we're just going to go for 6.5. You're going to select what operating system it is. We're going to say it's Windows 2016, 64-bit. All right, and next. You'll see this is the data store that we were talking about. So this is a data store that we've already pre-configured and defined within our ESXi or your vCenter environment. And say next. You can now customize your settings. So you can go ahead and do this later, but it's also a good thing to perhaps do it now. So you want to allocate how many CPUs do you want to give it, right? You can expand this and you can say, I want these many cores per socket. I can enable a few other features. How much RAM do I want to give it? You know, 4 gig of RAM, or I can give it more. What size hard drive do I want? All right, so we're gonna just leave it as 40. Nice guys in controller, we're gonna leave that as a default. And a few other things around your network adapter, your CD-ROM drive, video card, etc., etc. So that's the simple things that you wanna do. Under CD, DVD, Your operating system, when it boots up, is going to try to search for that ISO, and it will be mounted from your CD DVD. So now we're going to select that ISO from the data store that we just copied that ISO to. All right, and there it is. So my data store 01 temp, ISOs folder, and then there is my Windows 2016. All right, so from here, you're going to say next. And what this is going to do, if connected power on is powered on, then as soon as you boot up this new template, this new VM, it's going to automatically go and mount and boot from this ISO, which is 2016 Windows Server. Give you a summary of what we've just done, what we've configured, and we say finish. So you'll see that now I've got a new vCenter ISO, a new vCenter VM ready. It's going to boot from this ISO. So all I do is I can open it and then click on power on. All right, that is now going to start to power on. I can quickly now click on the console tab and it should open up, let's say, as a new tab. I should be able to now essentially console in. It's the same as if I'm in front of a physical computer of somewhat. And there you go. I'm now presented with your Windows login screen. So I just go through the simple steps here, the simple steps of just installing a brand new Windows Server 2016. All right, just going to start the setup, install, and then once it's done, you will have Windows Server configured. So we'll put the key in later on. We're going to be doing 2016 data center. You accept the terms. Custom. And here's the disk that we just selected. So 40 gig is the disk size that we saw that the data store had. And we allocated a disk of 40 gig. And we say next. And that will now start the install process. So it's copying the files and then it will go through the installation. Once the installation is complete, we then need to install a few other small things, but we'll check back after this. So that is now finished and it's presented with the basic Windows login screen here, where I'm going to configure a password. So put in a password that you want to use. And here we are. We're now logged in. So you can control or delete. And log into our Windows. And do some basic configuration from here. Now, once Windows has popped up, what we want to do is we want to go and configure or install VMware Tools. So VMware Tools is a piece of software that is going to be running on Windows that essentially will help you communicate better with the VMware infrastructure, right? With your ESXi host or with vCenter. So, you know, allow better functionality with your mouse, with your shortcuts, allows you to remotely control power on, power off, those sort of things from your VMware console. So it's always important to install VMware Tools. So let's go ahead and do VMware Tools install. So you select your VM that you just built, vCenter. You'll see that's the current screen, which we're seeing right now. And we want to click on Actions. You can click on Actions or you can right click on your vCenter itself, same thing. And you go Guest OS, install VMware Tools. All right, so back on our server. Sometimes you'll get a prompt and it'll automatically pop up on your screen. Otherwise, you may have to just physically go into Windows Explorer, for example. And you'll see that now your D drive is VMware Tools. So I can double click on this, and this will start the installation of VMware Tools. The other thing you want to make sure is that you keep VMware Tools updated. So every so often, go and check the version of VMware Tools that's available and push out a newer version of VMware Tools to your VM fleet as often as you can. All right, we're going to leave it all as standard and default and install. Installation will finish, you click on finish, and it will ask you to restart that VM. So just be mindful that every time you install VMware Tools or update VMware Tools, it's going to ask you to reboot your VM. So we're going to go ahead and say yes. And that is pretty much it. So that is the full installation, nice and easy. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you have any suggestions for any new videos for me as well, that would be fantastic. Like my video also, and we will talk to you next time.
So if you found that video helpful, please like it and subscribe to my channel, Digital Byte Computing, just on the button there for more videos.